advertise next. Why are they showing a jukebox? Yay.
Now, please welcome three-time NBA champion and two-time most valuable player from the Golden State Warriors, it's Stephen Curry.
Do not care.
What's going on? As some of you may know, I had my own gaming-related injury recently. I went for that triangle button, and next thing you know, I'm on the floor, you know, 2K is no joke, so. Once again, esports is the fastest growing sport on the planet, and still breaking records.
Not his laugh, the background
massive
laugh.
Massive multi-million dollar prize pools, and the award for best esports player recognizes both outstanding play, regardless of the game, and also good sportsmanship. So here are the nominees.
Kel.
Best esports player.
Don't care. How old is Faker now?
He tries to jump away, but Perth splashes forward, and the Stand United won't save you now.
And the game award for best esports player goes to.
Do not drop that.
Booga.
What? Please don't drop that. He's so young, though.
Thank you guys so much. This is like the best way to end off my year, honestly. thank you all to my fans, my family, my friends, my team Sentinels, and most importantly, Epic Games for making any of this possible. And I'm so glad to be a part of this community, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. Thank you guys so much.
Yay. What is this? No, seriously, what is this? Huh? I don't think I know this. Gearbox. Is this a new trailer? Godfall. Okay. We'll see. That was really uneventful. Okay. Shit's going down then.
PlayStation.
Jesus. PlayStation 5. It actually says PlayStation 5.
Oh, you noticed that. Yeah. PlayStation 5. All right. This show's on fire. I'm here with Keith Lee, the CEO of Counterplay, and Steve Gibson, the president of Gearbox Publishing. Guys, brand new announcement, brand new IP, new game. What is Godfall?
Godfall is a brand new IP set in a brand new fantasy universe filled with heroic knights and mysterious magic. We call it a looter slasher.
All right, so looter slasher, tell us a bit about like how is this going to play?
Jesus. So we're here to reinvent combat for loot-driven action RPGs. We'll have third-person,
finally,
real-time melee
Jesus
combat.
Fucking Christ, direction.
Awesome loot. You can also play the game in solo.
Do not have a deputy
well
director.
Co-op. It's going to be fun for everyone.
Well, it looks absolutely incredible. That was all in engine. You know, you can see the game that we're going to get to play there. Steve, you know, from Gearbox's point of view, you guys nominated tonight, obviously, Borderlands. Congrats on that. But how do you guys fit into this picture with Sony and with Counterplay?
Oh, man, you know we love our co-op and our gear at, at Gearbox. So here we are, man. When Keith showed us Godfall, it was so amazing to us. We had to call our friends over at Sony, our friends over at Epic. Say, hey, help us make this work on your technology and your hardware.
Mm.
Keith, we're going to do everything we can for you, man. And we're excited. We're so excited to announce this is going to be announced. This is launched exclusively on the PlayStation 5 Game Store this holiday.
All right, holiday 2020.
This holiday 2020.
We're going to get, all right, PlayStation 5 games. What's going on? All right, this is amazing. Well, guys, congratulations.
Yay.
It looks absolutely incredible. I'm sure we'll see more next year, right?
You sure will.
Awesome. All right. Congrats on the announcement. Awesome, guys. All right. Well, we'd like to welcome some, we'd like to recognize some other of our winners tonight. So in the category of best audio design for best in-game audio and sound design, those nominees are Call of Duty Modern Warfare,
audio
Control,
design.
Death Stranding,
not,
Gears
not
5,
Death Stranding, though.
Resident
it's
Evil
probably
2.
Gonna be like, it's probably going to be Call of Duty.
Favorite. And Sekiro Shadows Die Twice.
It does
and
have really
Game
good,
Award
really
goes
good sound
to
design.
Call of Duty Modern Warfare. Congratulations to the guys at Infinity Ward. All right. For best strategy game focused on real-time or turn-based strategy, those nominees are Age of Wonders Planetfall, Anno 1800.
Never heard of it.
Fire Emblem Three Houses.
The first one. Please.
Total War Three Kingdoms, Tropico 6, and Wargroove.
Wargroove might
win. And the Game Award in that category goes to Fire Emblem Three Houses.
Jesus fucking Christ. That is an amazing game.
The
also the only one I played.
Content Creator of the Year.
Don't care.
For a streamer or content creator who made an important and positive impact on the industry this year, the nominees are Courage, who's in the house here, Dr. Lupo, Ewok,
I was thinking of Dr. Disrespect.
And the Game Award goes to Shroud. Congratulations.
Don't know any of these guys.
All right. Well, we've had some great world premieres and announcements to start off the show, and we've talked about Xbox. We've talked about PlayStation, another platform we probably should talk about now. We have another world premiere, brand-new game announcement.
Brand-new game.
I don't think you guys are expecting, but we're really excited to share it with you here on the Game Awards. Check this out.
It's a game announcement, so it's not Zelda. Is it Metroid? Is it fucking Metroid? What the fuck? The fuck are you talking about, Square Enix?
It is time to choose. Accept your fate and await oblivion.
Oh, I don't like this so
or
far.
Or make a stand and fight for survival.
Bravely third.
Step into the light, young hero. Be brave.
It's Bravely Third. I mean, it's not necessarily going to be called Bravely Third. Bravely Default 2, just Bravely Default 2. Jesus fucking Christ. Bravely Default, Bravely Second, Bravely Default 2. Naming. Jesus. Fuck. Good job, though.
All right, right now I'm joined by my fellow Canadian, Rebecca Ford, Live Operations and Community Director at Digital Extremes. Is that for Canada or for Rebecca? For both of us. All right. Rebecca, welcome to the Game Awards. You've been up here before. Warframe, tell us, what's the latest on Warframe?
We've been making this game for 7 years, and each year we update it with the Space Ninja flair, but we think it's time to go Space Pirate, and this whole Empyrean thing is what our community wants to know about.
Yes, I know. You guys have teased that. What can you tell us about it? When's it going to come out?
Well, we were thinking on PC we would launch it right now.
Oh, okay. Here we go. So Empyrean live right now. All right, that's fantastic. And people will be able to get their hands on it tonight. Anything else that we should be keeping in mind?
Yeah, our PlayStation 4 and Xbox One 10 have the Rising Tide update, which means they are now preparing for Empyrean. Nintendo Switch will come soon. And it's really just, if you've been following Warframe's story, there's a lot to find in this update. So why not launch it on PC?
Okay, so it's out right now on PC, and
it's
we're going to take a look at it.
Yes.
Okay, check it out. Well, thanks, Rebecca. Let's take a look.
That's good. That's really good. Ninjas versus pirates. Or ninja pirates. I don't know anything about this game. Except Space Ninjas. Just, they are really stylish though. Really interesting. Nice.
Tonight we're happy to welcome Samsung as a new partner of the Game Awards, and throughout the night you'll be hearing from my fellow Canadian, lots of Canadians tonight, Linus Tech Tips about Samsung's QLED TVs,
Linus,
which are optimized for the best gaming experience.
His name is Tech Tips?
I'm Linus from Linus Tech Tips, and I'll be talking
about some of the
ways living room gaming
is better than
ever. When I was a kid, my first gaming TV was about this big, and it had a VHS player built into it. Not very immersive. With a Samsung QLED TV, not only can you see more than ever before, but at 4K resolution with sizes of up to 82 inches, the image clarity is unbelievable. And with Samsung's 10-year burn-in guarantee, you can game without
worry. Wow, 10-year burn-in guarantee.
My name is Soleil. Many people know me as Ewok. I am deaf, and I play Fortnite, and I'm 14. I was just a streamer with a very small following. In the past 14 months, everything's really taken off, and it's been absolutely incredible.
So that is not her voice.
I've become the first woman in FaZe Clan. My goal is to see many more females playing and considered at an equal level, and I really want to see that explode in the gaming world. I think that would be really
nice. So she doesn't use sound to play. That's interesting. It's really interesting.
And Ewok's here with us tonight.
I know that symbol.
All right.
I don't know.
Here with me now is Daniel Ketchum. He's the senior art director for Magic: The Gathering. Dan, welcome to the Game Awards.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
You're on brand. What's next?
Well, Jeff, I'm excited to tell you that in January, Magic will be returning to one of our most beloved worlds.
His name is Ketchum.
So the last time we went to Theros, a world of gods, myths, and monsters,
I can't take him seriously.
We saw our hero, Elspeth Tyrell, my favorite planeswalker, betrayed by the gods and banished to walk the underworld. But now our hero is ready to defy death and escape her fate. And I'm here to give you a sneak peek at what's in store for her. Now with music by Ramin Djawadi, this is the trailer for Theros Beyond Death.
All right, check it out. Thanks so much.
Nice presentation though. Uh-huh. A Ramin Djawadi is the guy who did the theme for Game of Thrones and Westworld. So yeah, he's kind of a big deal. I don't know what any of that means. Push her. This is a really cool trailer, though. Trailer. That is distressing and causes some anxiety. Cool. Black Lotus, are you serious? Did you have Black Lotus, or are you reintroducing it?
All right, the new game announcements just keep rolling here at the Game Awards. Eventually, we'll get some games you already know about, but let's keep going with things you haven't seen before. Here's another world premiere.
Fuck it. Oh, fuck yeah. Love these. Time to guess. Nope. Stop it. Stop it! Focus. What? Player unknown. Oh! Oh! Player unknown! Is that it?
Now, she's a creative director and the lead art designer from the Evil Within series. Please welcome Ikumi Nakamura.
He's awesome.
Please bear with my English. Okay?
I love her so much.
Good art can change over time, but great art stays great. Mm-hmm. Great art sparks joy in our brains and helps us to change the way we think. Because sometimes we need to change to survive. This year, I had a big change in my life, and it's been a crazy year.
Well, you're really bad, but you're cute, so yeah.
But I'm alive. Was it a crazy year for you? You are not alone, because I'm here.
Okay.
And we have great games with great art. Here are the nominees for Best Art Direction Meet.
Cool.
Best Art Direction presented by Samsung QLED.
I mean, this is flawless art direction, though. This is a... Oh, fuck. Shit! These are amazing nominees, by the way. Jesus fucking Christ, I could not guess who would win.
As you know, I am a fortune teller. I can see... Mieta. And And the winner is...
I already saw it.
Controller!
Yeah. That was kind of painful, though. Where the fuck were you going?
Wow. This is incredible. I'm trying to avoid any explicit language right now. I think the big thank you goes to the art director, Janne Pulkkinen. He is an amazing person. He's worked at Remedy for a long while, and he had this crystal clear vision of what he wanted to achieve with Control.
Yeah.
And he did amazing things together with his team. Also have to thank Stuart McDonald, who is the world design director, and Antti Puomi, who handled the characters and all the creepy monsters that existed in this game. And I can't imagine a better group of artists and talented creative people to work with. And this is thanks to you guys. Thank you so much for your work.
Yeah, they're clapping for her. I'm joking. They're very good. I know this guy.
All right, congratulations.
Oh, it's the guy from Fortnite,
Remedy.
Right.
We've got lots more awards coming up, but right now I'm here with Donald Mustard, worldwide creative director for Epic Games. Donald, welcome back to the game. It's a yearly thing, I feel like. We always get to hang out.
Yeah, it's fun. This is great.
Well, you guys have built quite a franchise in Fortnite, and the last couple years have just been so crazy for you guys, but what I love is that you're constantly innovating with this game.
That's what we're trying to know. It's you know, I think we're all just trying to make stuff that we think is fun, that we think is cool, and you never quite expect something to take off the way that Fortnite did, right? But once that momentum happened, we're just like, man, how do we just we gotta lean in, and how do we find ways to really just push the idea of what a persistent virtual place can be? And so that's why even this year.
Marshmallow,
you know,
concert,
like the concert, yeah. We start the year off with a concert that has, you know, over 10 million people in it. You know, we roll into, you know, huge monster fights, and we've got, you know, the thing we've been planning forever to, like, how do we find a way to suck the entire world into the zero-point black hole and turn the game off and like all this stuff.
But
that
all, in some ways, I think, pales in comparison to what's about to happen this weekend.
Something pretty cool is going to happen in a few hours, you know, and on Saturday.
On Saturday, you guys probably have seen teasing a little bit about something that's happening at Risky Reels, tied to Star Wars.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Right? Yes, and it's pretty cool.
What can you tell us about it?
You know, I probably can't tell you much, but I have a friend who can.
Okay. Let's take a look.
That's J.J. Abrams.
Thanks, Donald. Hey, everyone. It's J.J. Abrams, director of The Rise of Skywalker. Join me in Fortnite on Saturday for an exclusive look at the movie. To see the whole thing, you got to be in the game. So I'll see you in Fortnite on Saturday. Thanks.
Fuck you.
Yeah. This is so cool. And I think, you know, some people online have said, like, oh, you're just running a clip or whatever. And I don't know how much you want to reveal. But you and I have been talking all year about, you know, building a live experience around this. I'm excited. I'm going to get to actually be in the game as well, kind of interacting with JJ. And I don't know how much you want to tell us about it, but it's going to be a live participatory experience, right?
I think it's going to be like something that no one's ever seen before, ever. I mean, JJ and Jeff, we're going to be live.
Yes. Oh, and we're also, that's the glider we're going to get, I think.
There's
right?
also going to be that.
Exactly.
Wait, so hold on. That's
like
what happens.
Star Wars.
That's what happens when you do it live, exactly, right? Exactly. So
you never know. There's an attack happening.
Everyone who shows up, like as you drop out of the battle bus, you're all gonna pop those out. Like everyone that shows up is gonna get TIE whispers. Uh-huh. It's awesome. You're flying around, and JJ and Jeff will be there live in the game, and we're gonna see this awesome clip from Star Wars. It's brief, but I've seen it many times. It's very, very good. Yeah. You want to see it? And then some other crazy stuff is going to happen, and you should come.
Yeah, no, I'm really excited about sort of what this means, I think, for sort of
programming inside of games, shared experiences like the Game Awards, people all coming together watching this, but this is inside the game world. I'm really excited about what is going to happen on Saturday. So right from the Game Awards to that. But before then, I know you've got some other, some cool things that people can pick up in Fortnite,
right? We do. So there's one more thing. Yes. So right now, you can go to Fortnite, and these are now available in the game. They're some of my favorite characters of all time, Rey and Finn and the awesome new Sith Trooper, and they're in the game right now. You can go get it to get it loaded up for Saturday.
Cool.
Amazing.
Models
well,
are really
I gotta
good.
Say, we are really excited about what you guys have put together with you, Lucas, and Disney to have this come together this weekend. I know these things are never easy to pull off, but I'm really excited about what it's gonna be. So Saturday.
Everyone Saturday, 2 p.m. Right. Eastern, yep. And it's live. Like, we're doing it live, and it's going to be amazing and crazy, just right. Like this.
I was going to say, we'll be there, and there'll probably be TIE Fighters. There'll be other crazy things going on. Donald, thanks, as always, for coming by the Game Awards. Good luck. I know you guys are for a bunch of awards tonight as well. And we've got much more Game Awards coming
Thank
up.
Thank you.
Donald Mustard.
Later.
Thanks, everybody.
He got out of there fast.
We've got a lot of brand-new game announcements tonight. And this next one comes from a team up in my home country of Canada. I keep mentioning Canada, but this is a game that I think you'll be surprised by. And I saw it and I said, hey, this would be a cool thing to announce at the Game Awards. So check it out.
You're underplaying it. Something that would be nice. What? So, whoa. Is this a survival game about fighting demons? Dancing, though. What the hell? This is freaky. I don't quite get what this is. Okay. What? Is Innight the studio?
Sons of the Forest. We got some cool stuff tonight. All right. Well, one of the most played games in the world is League of Legends. And tonight, we're happy to have Riot and its new Riot Forge division with us to reveal their first single-player experience for the franchise.
Take a look at this. I'm curious about this.
My king.
Oh, fucking motion graphics,
Long
man.
Long have you waited.
You have so much money.
Now, the time has come for your revenge. A harrowing. Across all room terror, no fear.
Okay.
Ruin. They will know your name.
I don't know what it is because you haven't shown anything. Did motion graphics, which is
Ruined
nothing.
King, Airship Syndicate. I'm here with Joe Mad. Joe, you guys have made some amazing games over the years. First of all, congratulations
okay,
on working with Riot. The reveal of
you
guys making the first game,
Thank
what
you.
It is. Tell us more about what we just saw in that teaser.
Yeah, so I'm so excited we can finally talk about this. I was sure I would leak it before now, but we are doing the first ever Riot Forge game. And as you saw, it is The Ruined King, a League of Legends story. We're basically building on our experience making Battle Chasers and Darksiders to create a story-driven, turn-based RPG. We have a new take on turn-based combat that's really cool. Obviously, the art and visuals that our studio is known for. And the story takes place after Burning Tides. So everyone believes Gangplank is dead, Bilgewater is in chaos, and you'll actually play as some League champions and explore Bilgewater, the Shadow Isles, and we have a lot of other surprises as well. And Poros, they're mandatory, apparently.
All right, well, it sounds like this is something you've been working on for a little while, too, right?
We have, yes. And I can't say any more.
Okay, that's all you're allowed to say.
Oh,
right,
Jesus,
well,
he has a fucking Naruto tattoo. I like him
for
immediately.
The first time. Joe,
he's
you guys,
Jesus.
The game's so far amazing, and it's just an honor to be here.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much for announcing it with us. It means the world to us. And I know all the League of Legends fans around the entire world who are tuned in tonight. So, Joe, congratulations.
I can't wait to hear what you guys think.
You'll
Thank
be
you.
On the social medias, right?
What's the right arm tattoo?
Thank you very much, Joe Mack.
Thank you.
Great announcement. League of Legends. Fantastic.
When we come back, a performance by Grimes.
Yay.
The award for best action game.
Sorry, is there
going to
be
Reedus,
a commercial break?
And a special announcement from an Apex legend. Still to come, Ninja presents best multiplayer game and an extended look at Ghost of Tsushima. This is the Game Awards. Don't
Norman
go anywhere.
Norman Reedus was good.
I said no.
Come on, Harley.
We've been here training for weeks.
Don't take this the wrong way or nothing, but you guys just aren't really Birds of Prey material. No offense.
But I love you.
Of course you do, Schnookums. Now quit messing around. Let's give these people what they want.
What do they...
Ladies, if you want boys to respect you, you have to show them that you're serious. Blow something up. Hit someone. Nothing gets a guy's attention like violence.
Oh, I love this chick. She's got rage issues.
I don't have rage issues!
This might actually be fun. Cow, it was a trailer. That is a pretty good commercial. They are very consistent, so Doom.
Against all the evil that hell can conjure.
Mm-hmm.
All the wickedness that mankind can produce, we will send unto them. Only you.
Yeah.
We heard you may want to quit vaping.
But we can't help you. We can barely hold these protest signs.
But we can tell you about This Is Quitting, an easy text to quit service. It's the least
and most we can do.
Interesting.
Mommy is dead, Hugo. You'll never see her again. Hugo, down!
You can't keep running forever.
You are a monster. A monster. You have yet to see just
how. Should I play this? Oh, Jesus, maybe I should play this.
Be sure to stay in the light.
Nice. Game Awards sale. Maybe I should get on that. I need to take these out.
Who's it gonna be? Stay tuned.
Welcome back to the Game Awards. All right, music is a big part of games, and Cyberpunk 2077 is one of the most anticipated games coming out next year. Well, hello to everyone at CD Projekt Red. They're over in Poland and working hard to finish the game. But right now, we've got a behind-the-scenes look at the soundtrack to Cyberpunk 2077. Check it out.
Even in the dystopian future, hard rap lives on.
We want to provide you with the soundtrack to fucking shit up.
I mean, we're not here as refuse, we're here as samurai. It's a very interesting thing to be part of.
We really work on these songs, trying to make them as good as possible.
I think my music fits with my city because both are scary and pretty at the same time.
My music will be featured in Cyberpunk 2077. I'm super excited.
Okay.
It's quite rebellious and it's quite noisy and aggressive. I think industrial is the word.
I can't wait to see how the two worlds actually meet. I mean, it's been a lot of fun playing these beats.
It's very punk rock in the way in its approach. You're building these systems to make really rugged, rough, edgy music.
Noise.
Psychedelic, trippy, yet uplifting and engaging.
And you can see a lot of kind of industrial stuff and revolution happening.
Sort of mixing punk music
and
electronic music could be in the future.
So we have some tracks that are super dirty, super heavy, and then we have some tracks that are very beautiful and ambient.
That was just a glimpse of what we have in store for you. See you in Night City.
A concert would be nice. Oh, Grimes, right. Oh. This is fully cyberpunk themed. Oh, fuck. That's how you do a presentation, man. Are those tattoos, or is that bodysuit? Oh, I mean, there wouldn't be actual tattoos, so yeah, bodysuit. Body paint, maybe. Interesting. Some Hindi. I think it's... reminds me of Diwani. Nice playback. You don't have to sing. Is that something we're gonna see in game? That would be nice. I think this is a sample from Diwani. Just do this. I don't need a live performance. It's fucking pretty though. This is definitely Indian inspired. Yup. Increasingly. That's how you do that. Oh, there he is. He's next to the cute girl. Is he long? Going up.
I'm
And now, he's the star of The Walking Dead and a Best Performance nominee tonight for his role as Sam Porter Bridges in Death Stranding. Here's Norman Reedus.
Oh, they said Walking Dead. They meant to say Walking Dead. They said Walking Dad.
Hello. What's up? What's up? Hi. All right, it's time to present the award for Best Action Game. These games are all wildly different. Some new franchises, some beloved sequels, all with their own unique adversaries and objectives. But the one thing that they have in common is that they set the bar for lively combat and thrills. All right, ready? All right. Nominees. Here's the nominees.
Yeah. Jesus fucking Best Christ, that was scary. Game.
Try and keep up.
Action game is such a vague category. No interest in these.
Have to kick some ass.
Please give it to Devil May Cry, because this is what I think of when I think of of action game.
All right, this is heavy, and the winner is Devil May Cry 5.
Fuck yeah. Reject. Reject the shooter thing. That's why the shooter category exists.
Thank you so much.
Totta de. Devil May Cry 5 に携わってもらったすべてのスタッフの皆さん、感謝します。そして11年間待ってくれたデビルメイクライシリーズのファンの皆さん、ありがとうございます。
Thank you so much for all the fans who have been supporting us, and thank you so much for waiting 11 years for the sequel.
浮気せずにまっすぐにアクションゲームを作ってきて本当に良かったと思ってます。
Really happy to stick with my roots and trying to make as pure of an action game as possible.
Yep. Is that Kamiya?
DMC is back! Thank you!
Go on, Norman.
Congrats to the DMC guys. All right, I'm now joined
You're
by
scary.
Jeff Adam, the studio lead and founder of Took Games from Canada. I don't know how it all works out that way, but a lot of Grimes, Canadian, Jeff. All right, anyways, tell us what you've been working on up at Took.
Thanks, Jeff. Toop. I'm super excited to be here with the world premiere of the game we've been working on up in Montreal. Salut tout le monde. When we started working on this game, we had the idea to put action back
in
action
RPGs. You are 30% nose.
And what better place than in Dungeons & Dragons, Forgotten Realms, Icewind Dale. Slay together with your friends. I'm super pleased to announce Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance.
Let's check it out.
Cool. Yeah, please make it a fun game. What the fuck? This is pretty cool. It's a really interesting approach for a trailer. Cow.